Hello and greetings from Iceland. Yet again, I have some big news, and it will be my thermal drone that will be the center of attention in today's update. But I just got back from a longer road trip, and I actually left a half-made video behind when I took off last week, a video that covered landrise by Fagradalsfjall volcano. But what my thermal drone found during the road trip turned out to be a big part of that unfolding story. So here we are, once again. This is where the last eruption took place, and experts have been mentioning that we could have to wait until January, or even longer, for the next show. But as always, it's just impossible to say, and this might just as well fade out. But the frequency of those events alone is newsworthy for sure. So let's rewind to July for the bigger picture. There was a volcanologist saying back then, during the eruption, that we might just as well see some new vents open up closer to the mountain killer, but that didn't happen, although we might have come close to it. But I did do a thermal scan there 3 days into the eruption, and what that scan told me is that there were clearly some abnormalities going on there, so I'm linking to that video, and this area did actually remain closed during the eruption, or restrictions that were not good for my channel. My thermal drone has limited range over terrain like this for some reason, and despite my efforts to bypass those restrictions, it didn't work out. But the road to the mountain killer is now open again, and it's getting colder, which is excellent for thermal scanning, so I gave it a go to see if I could detect something new, and I sure did. The area that was closed and I wanted to scan is actually above the dike that fed all three eruptions so far, and originated deep down under Keilir. And the first thermal image of the day was shot around here, and we can see the lava fields on Fagradalsfjall 10 kilometers away. And this is just to give you an idea about the sensitivity of the camera. I was also picking up some signals from some of those ridges there, not strong, but I detected them before, so I'm little by little collecting images from what could be abnormalities. Maybe not useful today, but could be so later. And this time I wanted my scan to be a bit more organized. I was trying to find the best altitude, camera angles and such. And this kind of work needs a whole lot of practice if it's going to be done like it should be done. And I drained my first two batteries over this area, and I didn't come up with much there, but then I noticed something a bit further east, so I moved my takeoff spot to this old crater called Eldborg that sadly has been ruined. The red gravel was most likely used for roads. I've actually been driving by here numerous times and I know this area quite well, and I instantly found the strong signals behind the crater, so strong that I didn't need a thermal camera, since when I got closer, I found steam coming up from the ground, and I wasn't actually sure if it was normal or not. I don't recall seeing steam coming up from there before, so a big part of my work is to sort out what is normal, what used to be there, or not. But the findings this time, they were very obvious, so I drained the last drone battery, and I did report my findings to a professor at the university that obviously liked my video and told me that they would be placing thermometers there this Monday. And those responses got me even more curious, of course. So I took off again 2 days later, but it turned out to be impossible to do any scanning that day due to rain. But I managed to do some scanning in the next valley to the east, and I still haven't found the time to go over those files and sort out what areas are known to be hot or not. But at least I have a good comparison video from there, if I will have to scan there again for some reason, and I do suspect that I will someday, because the reason I was scanning in this valley is simple. In the year 1151, a 25 kilometer long fissure opened across the peninsula. It ran through this valley, it was not continuous, but showed us quite well how insignificant those eruptions are that we have been getting already. And shortly before I shot this, the sun had been shining for a little while, enough to make everything look like a glowing Christmas tree once again. So I'm using this clip to show you how hard it is to do thermal scans when it's not cold. But let's move to day number 3 on the lava fields, or September 10th. Again, I stopped by Eldborg craters and I found instantly this major change. Steam coming up from the ground just by the road, and this was not there the day before. And just by where I had found clear heat signals the day before, it was also steam there. The outdoor temperature was similar, so it was quite clear that there was change between days. And since I came back with fresh batteries, I scanned a larger area this time, and I'm starting by showing you this area between the crater and our capital, thinking about those unfortunate souls that picked this location for the city that we see here in the background. And we can also see an aluminium smelter by the city limits lit up 10 kilometers away, and midst between the city and the drone, there were clearly some abnormalities there. They were actually a bit too far away for the drone, but they need to be looked at with more accuracy. And I would have hiked there if I had the time, but I had already added 2 days to the trip to follow up on this thermal scan findings. But closer by, I got very strong heat signals from this fractured ridge, and I did find more that should be looked into. But in order to get a good reading, I will have to get very close from different takeoff spots. The outside temperature was around 10-12 degrees those days, making the scanning way easier than last summer. But I think that when I'm down to 5 degrees and no sun, it's going to be the best conditions I can get, especially when it comes to scanning larger areas. And if it gets colder than that, it's not going to be good for the drone or the drone batteries. So I am getting somewhere with this. Always learning. And those of you who are new to my channel, you need to know that I'm not the expert when it comes to the geology. I'm just documenting this as well as I can using modern technology and often coming back from our road trips with more questions than answers on my memory cards. But this situation was actually mentioned in the media last Sunday as magma most likely closer to the surface than usual. But I haven't heard anything about a potential eruption around there. It occurred to me that this was just some kind of offspring from the intrusion that led to the last eruption. We are now only 10 kilometers away from the city limits, and the media hasn't even covered our building policy properly since this started 30 months ago. And the thermal drone was funded 80% by subscribers who believed me when I told them that this could be useful, or so I thought, after looking into this technology. And I do still think that this could even be a part of the civil defense warning system, since it has proven to be extremely useful as for accuracy. And my guess is that this will not be the only drone in Iceland used for such tasks after some time, because if the university doesn't get one soon, I would be very surprised. So I'm using the chance now, again, to say thank you to those of you who helped me to buy this tool, because this investment will do only good things here in Iceland. So I came home with more thermal footage than ever before, and I need some time to go through it, cut out the useless bits and sort the rest. And as for the overall situation on the peninsula, there has been strong seismic activity all over the place, and I would not be surprised if the next eruption is only weeks away, and not necessarily where I was shooting the thermal footage. But the location might follow the trend from the first 3 eruptions, keep on moving to north and east, closer to the city. But my problem is, however, to get someone to analyze the footage for my channel, since I'm not a scientist. I'm just the guy who shoots the photos and videos that have question marks all over them. And I know for a fact that there are scientists watching my channel. So, as always, feel free to share your wisdom in the comment section about the situation. And I had other things to do for the channel in this trip, like leaving my DJI Air 2S drone at a dealership to be repaired. It was driving me a bit crazy during a Highland volcano photo tour the other day. So, I picked up a new DJI Air 3 drone and it's a fabulous thing. Much needed upgrade for longer range, battery lifetime, zoom capabilities, and many other new or improved functions. I still don't know what's wrong with the old drone, but it has this extremely wide lens that is often very useful, so I want to keep it as a backup drone, since there are times when I need it. So I came back with lots of footage to edit this winter, like I shot a video on the way back for my town series. I haven't been making that many episodes lately, and then it's the P1000 Super Zoom camera I have, and I admit fully that I haven't used it very much. And finally, I found the seal on the way back home north, and it literally screamed of joy when I came to ask him to say hello to my viewers. And then he waved to you all. So I promise you more of this soon. Plenty of good stuff waiting to be edited. This new zoom camera will open up a whole new world for the channel, not just faraway volcanoes that will be hard to capture on film, but this was, however, the trip when the thermal drone got to shine, and it provided me with good practice and the data to see how this increased ground temperature will develop. Since, after all, I am documenting an event that is going to take perhaps 200 or 300 years more to unfold fully, according to scientists, and my channel might get to document the first 20-30 years properly, if I'm lucky. A part of the thrill for me is to look over the peninsula and try to imagine how it will look like in 10 years, 50 years, or even 200. 70% of the nation lives on this tiny little peninsula, the youngest part of Iceland, that is behaving as such, or unpredictable prankster, still forming. So what will become of it? Will we get another huge shield volcano formation or something else? So I have endless questions. But as for now, I need to do some work up north, and I would like to do my next thermal scan trips when it gets a bit colder. And it won't be long now. It's the only thing that you know for sure about the Icelandic weather. It never fails to get colder. But I don't have endless sources to stay away for days, especially since I drained my tool and travel budget like never before due to those drone problems and Icelandic travel cost that tourists know just as well as me. But on the positive side, I'm better equipped than ever before. That will help the channel to grow, of course, and despite the problems I had with my old drone in my last volcano trip on the highlands, I did come back with plenty of good files that I'm working on now, and they will be extremely useful into the future. So, as usual, there are ways to support my work listed in the video description, links to my print-on-demand stores, and I will in the next days be uploading some shorter videos, but most importantly, waiting for more information about what's going on. And I suspect that I will find a good reason to make a new update soon covering the Reykjanes Peninsula. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.